welcome to my channel. This is an extra video today, as well as my two usual art videos that will be on the normal days of Monday and Thursday. So I do apologise if you've joined me today wanting an art demonstration. Today I'm going to actually be talking about my YouTube channel and growing your YouTube art channel. So the real reason for doing this was because of the new changes to the monetization and the YouTube partnership program. So I'm sure that you can't have missed all of these videos that have been on over the last 4 weeks regarding the changes. So if you have missed them, basically the changes are to become monetized, i.e. in order to run ads on your YouTube videos and to make money from your YouTube channel, you now need to have 1,000 subscribers and 4,000 hours of watch time in the course of the last year. So although my channel hasn't been affected, I have been taking quite a close interest in this and watching a lot of the small YouTuber videos, mainly because I want to give them the watch time. So I've kept watching quite a few of these channels that are affected because they've had a month to increase that watch time and to hopefully stay monetized. So I've kept watching quite a few of them. And I've noticed that there are quite a few art channels that are affected. So if you would like to help these small art channels with less than 1,000 subscribers to keep their monetization or to quickly regain their monetization after today, then can I suggest that you go and subscribe to them when you do see them and come across them. But also, I think more importantly, that you do watch the videos, because a lot of YouTube's algorithm works on the watch time, and this 4,000 hours of watch time is quite a lot to get in the space of a year. So if you could go and watch some of the smaller YouTuber art channels, that would be great to help support those. So if you are below that threshold and you're wondering whether you should carry on or give up, because there's been an awful lot of talk about people giving up because they feel very disheartened. I can understand why they feel disheartened, because basically YouTube have moved the goalposts. Hopefully they won't move them again. But also that little bit of money gives you a bit of an incentive, and it gives you an idea of how well your channel's doing as well. So it's something always to aim to. And when you take away that incentive, people can soon become very demoralised. So it's not necessarily about the amount of money, it's more the fact that they've taken away that incentive from you. So another reason I chose to do this video today was because I'm actually approaching 2,000 subscribers, and I did want to tell those of you that are growing your channels at the moment, that are under that 1,000, that actually it does take less time than you think if you're quite persistent. So the main thing is to upload regularly. But apart from that, I think as art channels, we're in actually quite a good position, because like I said just a little earlier, the emphasis from YouTube really is on watch time. So if you can keep people engaged for quite a while with a tutorial or demonstration, it's much easier to gain that watch time than some other YouTube channels, perhaps ones that are doing animations and things where you've only got a 2-minute video or a 5-minute video. Some of our videos can be half an hour long or more, and that makes it much easier for you to crank up that watch time. So I think as an art channel, we're actually in a strong position for getting to that 1,000 and 4,000. So today is the 20th, and that's actually the last day for you to be able to gain those 1,000 subscribers and 4,000 hours of watch time. So what I'm really going to be looking at over the next few weeks in my analytics is to see whether that CPM changes dramatically, because I think the whole idea behind YouTube's decision was to increase the CPM for those that are above that threshold, because there'll be fewer people having ads, so really the CPM should go up. If you don't know what CPM is, it's cost per milli, or i.e. cost per thousand. Again, that varies quite a lot depending on the countries where people are viewing your videos, the time of year, the time of day, all sorts of things can affect that CPM, and it goes up and down all the time. But I'd be really interested to see if that goes up over the next few weeks. So if you've got any comments on that, or anything you'd like to ask me about growing my channel, growing your own art channel, if you want to put those in the comments below. If you've got any insight into what you think is going to happen with the CPM over the next few weeks as well, that would be interesting for me. But also, don't be disheartened if you are below that threshold, because I really think as an art channel we're in a good position to get those views and get that watch time, which is the most important thing. So for those of you who don't have your own channel and have just come across this video, If you do have some favourite YouTubers, whether it be art channels or any other type of channel, that are under 1,000 subscribers, or even those that are slightly above, because they may not have the view time even if they've got some of the subscribers, please do, if you enjoy the videos, do subscribe to them and do keep watching them. And thank you for watching me today, and like I say, any comments below, that would be great, and I look forward to seeing you again soon with my next art video on Thursday. Thanks for watching, and bye for now.